Welcome to JVI classes. In previous classes, we discussed about respiratory system. The important phenomena in the respiratory system is gaseous exchange. Okay, today we discuss about evolution in gaseous exchanging system. You know, the gaseous exchange is an important phenomena in all living organism. So the gaseous exchange is common in all living organism, but is different from organism to organism. Okay, and right now we discuss about gaseous exchange in unicellular organism. For example, amoeba. Amoeba is an unicellular organism, and some multicellular organisms like Hydra and Planaria, they show the gaseous exchange by the process of diffusion. Do you know what is diffusion? Diffusion is, that is the materials that passes from high concentration to low concentration. So by this process of diffusion, gaseous exchange takes place in some unicellular organisms. So it is a simple method in gaseous exchange. And the respiratory organs are differentiated by a living organism that leaves their habitat. For example, some organism lives in water. Those are aquatic organisms and some terrestrial organisms. Okay. So both organisms that show different kind of gaseous exchange system. Okay. So the respiratory organs are differentiate in the base of habitat and their body size and availability of water and type of circulatory system. Okay. So this is the important part. So the respiratory organ differentiate on the based upon one is habitat, and second one is their body size, and third one is availability of water, and fourth one is type of circulatory system. Okay, let us discuss types of respiration. So based upon respiratory system, we discuss four types of respirations. That is, one is tracheal respiration. Second one is using gills respiration. And third one is cutaneous respiration. And fourth one is pulmonary respiration. Let us discuss about tracheal respiration. So most of the insects, so all the insects like cockroach, grasshopper, that shows tracheal respiration. Here, this is the one of the example diagram, that is a cockroach. So in a tracheal respiration, the gases is directly enters into their tissues. There is no more other organs are present. Okay, in tracheal respiration, at the sides of their body cavity, a small pores are seen. These are called as spiracles. Okay, and a reticulate tracheal system is seen inside their bodies. That is a tubular structure that is nothing but trachea. Okay, the environmental gases pass through spiracles and enters directly into their tissues. So the gaseous exchange takes place at tissue level directly from environment. Okay, and then at the same way, the carbon dioxide are expelled out through tracheal system and through spiracles. So the carbon dioxide send out from spiracles. At that same time, oxygen enters into their body through spiracles. So this is the tracheal system is seen in insects. In insects, we see tracheal respiration. And second one is gill respiration. So, gill respiration is commonly seen in aquatic organisms because of the organism which lives in water. How can they receive oxygen? Okay, they receive oxygen in a dissolved state. Okay, the oxygen is dissolved in water and it consume the oxygen from water. So that the respiratory organs also, turn like this. For example, in fish, the best example is fish. In fish, how gaseous exchange takes place? So commonly, a fish receives water through its mouth and after it closes its mouth and then it increases the pressure in the buccal cavity of fish and then it suppresses its buccal cavity and then the pressure is increased and then automatically water may pass through their gill slits. When they hear a small reticulate structures, a small web-like structures are seen in gill pouches. The water transfers through or the water passes through or the water currents pass through these gills. Then the small blood vessels, that means capillaries receives oxygen from water as well as they send out the carbon dioxide into the water. So in this process, fishes commonly respire through gill slits. Okay, so all the gill slits are covered by gill lamellae. Okay, so this is the respiration is seen in fish, that is gill respiration. Okay, and next one is cutaneous respiration. So what is cutaneous respiration? The respiration takes place by skin is called cutaneous respiration. Most commonly in earthworms and frogs in the time of hibernation and aestivation, they show the cutaneous respiration. So what is cutaneous respiration and how it is possible? That gases exchange. So commonly in frogs or on earthworm surfaces have mucus glands on its skin. The mucus secretes on the surface of their skin. And the skin get wet. Okay, and moisture. Then the environment gases such as oxygen dissolve in mucous membrane. Okay, so the oxygen dissolve in mucus and enters into their tissues. Most commonly is seen in earthworms. In earthworm, it commonly shows the cutaneous respiration. Okay, so at the same time, utilized oxygen and they release carbon dioxide is also mixes with this mucus and send out from their body by the process of diffusion. Diffusion takes place in earthworms and in frogs at the time of hibernation and aestivation. Okay, so this is the cutaneous respiration. The cutaneous respiration is the respiration takes place by skin. Okay, and fourth one, pulmonary respiration. We already discussed about pulmonary respiration. Most of the birds, mammals and reptiles and some amphibians like frog, they show pulmonary respiration. In pulmonary respiration, mainly it is completely evolved and forms one pair of lungs. on pair of lungs and the tiny air-like structures are called alveoli. In the alveoli, the gaseous takes place by the process of diffusion. We already discussed about the structure of lungs. So, this pulmonary respiration is commonly seen in mammals, birds, and reptiles, and some amphibians also. Okay, so the types of respiration, one is tracheal respiration, is commonly seen in arthropods, such as insects, and gill respiration is commonly seen in fish, and the tadpole stage of frogs, and cutaneous respiration is mostly done by skin, is seen in earthworms and in some stages of frogs' life cycle. And finally, pulmonary respiration, it is done by one pair of lungs. Okay, so this is the types of respiration. And then, how can respiration takes place in plants? Like animals, plants also respires air, you know that. Okay, then generally plants can show the gases exchanged by the small pores are seen in leaves. Those are nothing but stomatas. While we observe the leaf in microscope, a small pores are seen in leaf. That is nothing but stomata. In stomatas, the gaseous exchange takes place by stomata. One pair of kidney-shaped cells are seen in stomata. Those are God cells. Here, gaseous exchange takes place by diffusion. Here also, diffusion. By diffusion, the gaseous exchange takes place in stomata. Okay, and in some plants, the gaseous exchange takes place by bark. On bark, some pores are there, those are called as lenticels. On lenticels, the gaseous exchange through lenticels. Okay, so that is respiration in plants. Most commonly, we see in plants, these are one lining, or one cell thick linings are seen in plants. So here, when the air enters through lenticels or stomatas, then the gaseous exchange takes place and sends towards entire the body tissues, plant tissues. Okay, and next one is a specific areas, and some plants grows in a specific area like muddy area or moisture area or brackish area and waterlogged areas or marsh areas. In marsh areas, then the plants that shows the aerial roots, that is the roots, the root penetrates into the deep soil, but in mangroves, the roots were show aeration. So by the help of the aerial roots, the gaseous exchange takes place because of the soil may not loosely packed. Because of the water is stagnated in that area, the gases may not take place by roots. So that some aerial roots are also seen in some plants like mangroves. So this is the information about aerial roots. So the evolution in gaseous exchange system from unicellular organism to multicellular organism is in different, it shows different methods. Okay, so this is the evolution, right? Okay, so in this topic we got 1 or 2 marks, most commonly seen 1 mark questions. So children, read carefully entire line to line, and then Right. And then you complete the task. Okay? Thank you.